Hello friends, I'm Dr. Shuchita Batra. I'm a consultant gynecologist at Ludhiana Gastro and Gynae Center, and I am a certified board cosmetic gynecologist by Indian College of Cosmetic Gynecology. So, आज हम लोग डिस्कस करेंगे लेबियाप्लास्टी के बारे में. क्या होता है लेबियाप्लास्टी, किसको करवाना चाहिए, क्या इससे कोई प्रॉब्लम्स आ सकती हैं, एंड मैक्सिमम रिजल्ट किस तरीके से मिले, इस चीज के बारे में हम लोग डिस्कस करेंगे. सो व्हाट इज लेबियाप्लास्टी एंड हु आर द कैंडिडेट्स फॉर लेबियाप्लास्टी. सो द इनर लेबियल फोल्ड विच इज द लेबिया माइनोरा इज द मेन कल्प्रिट विच कॉजेस डिफिकल्टी व्हाइल हैविंग आइदर इंटरकोर्स or in case after the childbirth it increases in size, or even if somebody is aging it can get lax over a period of time, and somebody might have just irregular set of labia, just like irregular size in the breasts. So these are some of the reasons why you might need a labiaplasty. Now who are the candidates for this? Jo maine aapko abhi bataye, like a person who has undergone childbirth, a person who is aging, or maybe they are having asymmetrical labia, along with that there is an increased awareness, there is a increased trend towards wearing tighter clothes, just like yoga pants or swimwear, which might display the labia in any abnormal position. So it is always better if you are having such kind of a problem, so either go for a loose clothes or maybe go for a labiaplasty. Then increase in the size of the labia, it can also interfere with the sexual intercourse, it can also interfere with the regular hygiene maintenance, or maybe the patient can have recurrent pelvic infections or recurrent urinary tract infections because of increase in the size. So these are the people who can have it. Now what are the prerequisites? Prerequisites ka matlab kya hota hai, kaun se patients फिट है करवाने के लिए और कौन से पेशेंट्स नहीं करवा सकते. सो फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट थिंग इज द एब्सेंस ऑफ स्मोकिंग. कोई भी पर्सन अगर बाय चांस स्मोकिंग कर रहे हैं, सो दे हैव टू लीव इट एटलीस्ट 2 months प्रायर टू द लेबियाप्लास्टी, बिकॉज वैस्क्यूलैरिटी इज द की हियर. वी कैन नॉट कॉम्प्रोमाइज द रिजल्ट्स बिकॉज ऑफ द स्मोकिंग. सेकेंड थिंग इज दे शुड बी फिजिकली फिट. फिजिकली फिट क्या होता है, द पर्सन शुड नॉट हैव डायबिटीज. अगर डायबिटीज है या हाइपरटेंशन है, दैट शुड बी प्रॉपरली अंडर कंट्रोल, एंड थायराइड डिसऑर्डर्स है, दे शुड बी प्रॉपरली अंडर कंट्रोल. दे शुड नॉट बी ऑन एनी काइंड ऑफ ब्लड थिनिंग एजेंट्स, बिकॉज ब्लड थिनिंग एजेंट्स दे कैन कॉज ब्लीडिंग एट द साइट ऑफ द रिपेयर एंड दैट कैन हैम्पर विद द रिजल्ट्स. सो ब्लड थिनिंग एजेंट्स आर जस्ट नॉट अलाउड. अगर आप किसी तरीके के पेन के लिए भी एस्पिरिन वगैरह ले रहे हैं, सो यू हैव टू tell to your doctor and you have to stop it at least a month before you go for the surgery. Now what are the labiaplasty procedures, kaise karte hain? So there are mainly 2 kinds of procedures. One is the edge and the another is wedge. In the edge procedure, a thin strip is taken up from both the labias, which is the abnormal strip, and the remaining part is stitched so that it gives the look of a normal labia and it gets hidden behind the labia majora. Another is wedge, jinka labia irregular hota hai bahut zyada, ya childbirth ke baad agar bahut significantly increased labia size ho jayega, then you cannot do an edge. There is need to be doing a wedge resection in which the crenated edges can be at least made straight and symmetrical. Then what are the precautions that you have to take before, and what are the precautions that you have to take after the labiaplasty? So labiaplasty is a cosmetic procedure, plus it's a functional procedure as well. So before the surgery you have to make sure that you are free of any kind of infection. Agar aapko kisi bhi tarike ka vaginal discharge hai, koi urinary tract infection hai, ya fir pain during intercourse hai, so get your gynecologist into loop. Second thing is the menstruation. It is always better to get the procedure done just after the periods have got over, and to delay the periods in case agar aapke periods just aane wale hain, because that is going to make the surgical site more messy and prone for infection. Then you cannot wear any kind of tight clothes after the surgery is performed for at least 6 to 8 weeks. It is always preferable not to have intercourse for at least 6 to 8 weeks after the surgery, and the maintenance of hygiene is paramount. इसके साथ कंपोनेंट्स क्या आते हैं, मेनी पीपल दे गेट कंफ्यूज्ड वेदर दे शुड गो फॉर अ आइस पैक और दे शुड अप्लाई अ हीटिंग पैक. सो आफ्टर द सर्जरी इज डन इट्स ऑलवेज एडवाइजेबल आप आइस पैक्स को यूज करें एंड दैट इज गोइंग टू रिड्यूस द इंफ्लेमेशन. पेन किलर्स एस्पिरिन वाला नहीं होना चाहिए. पेन किलर शुड ऑलवेज बी आइदर पैरासिटामोल और टाइलेनॉल. एनी ऑफ दीज थिंग्स कैन बी यूज बट नेवर अ ब्लड थिनिंग एजेंट. देन शावर, वेन टू शावर. सो द प्रोसेस इट्स अ सिंगल डे प्रोसेस. द नेक्स्ट डे यू आर गोना गेट होम. इनफैक्ट यू कैन गो होम द वेरी सेम डे बट यू कैनॉट हैव बाथ ऑन द सेम डे. नेक्स्ट डे यू कैन हैव अ बाथ बट मेक श्योर टू ड्राई द स्टिचेस साइट immediately after you have a bath and maybe apply a little bit of bacitracin ointment or betadine powder or ointment maybe once or twice a day. Over enthusiastic application se jo stitches hote hain wo prematurely dissolve ho jayenge and you will not get the proper results. Now what are the stitches used? The stitches which are used are mainly absorbable stitches, so there is no need to remove them. So these are the basic things that you must know before you undergo a labiaplasty. So in the end, I would like to summarize it in such a way that who is gonna need a labiaplasty. So there can be functional reasons, there can be cosmetic reasons. Functional reasons may the enlarged labia might be interfering with intercourse. They might be interfering with proper maintenance of hygiene, or they may be causing recurrent urinary tract infections, or they may be see-through the tight clothing or something like that. And regarding the cosmetic aspect, there can be an asymmetry. A person might not be comfortable with the genitalia, the external genitalia that they have, and they can undergo a limited kind of a resection. The procedure can be done under the local anesthesia as well as the general anesthesia. It depends upon the comfort of the patient, their prerequisites, what they want. But it is usually a procedure that lasts around 1 hour or 1.5 hours. And post procedure, the patient is free to get discharged approximately 4 to 6 hours after the procedure. So the patient can walk back home, but we expect that patient not to drive and to be easy on walking for the next 2 to 3 days, as well as keep on applying ice packs for the next 2 to 3 days. So that is it. I hope I was able to answer a lot of questions regarding the labiaplasty procedure. And in order to know more, you may book appointment by clicking on the link, or you may call on the given number and we will be happy to help. And my next video is going to be about how to prepare for a labiaplasty and what to be done after the labiaplasty. So do subscribe to our channel, do like the videos, and keep asking more questions. Thank you.